was a quiet night. I remember being completely drunk in my office. I didn't have many clients at that time, and I was running out of pretty much everything. The only thing that was really bothering me was that annoying green light from the hotel next door. Suddenly the phone rang, an unexpected call at an unexpected moment. That, my friends, in my neighborhood, could only mean one thing. Trouble. Who's disturbing my rest at this hour?
I'm sorry, Mr. Hammond. I'm desperate. My wife has been taken.
Who is this?
I'm Kovacs. Bertrand Kovacs. Maybe you don't remember me. I'm a friend of George Smithers.
Smithy.
Yes, Smithy. Listen, I am in grave danger, and Smithy is too. They have taken my wife. I don't know what to do.
They?
Please, listen. She never came back from work yesterday, and Smithy is not answering his phone. I left a package for you, so you can find Elizabeth. Smithy told me only you could find her. Find them, and make them pay.
Look, pal, hold on a second. First, I'm no hitman. Second, it's late, I'm drunk and tired. Why don't you come tomorrow afternoon so we can chit-chat all you want and talk about money?
Mr. Hammond, I think you don't understand. If you don't help us now, we'll be dead for tomorrow morning.
Okay, I see. What if I say yes? What's in it for me?
I have lots of money, Mr. Hammond. Don't worry about that. But I can't pay much now. I left $500 hidden in Smithy's house. I'll pay more when you get us out of this mess.
Okay, then. You've got yourself a deal. All I can promise is that I'll do everything in my power to find your wife. Try to keep your head down. We'll talk again soon.
Okay. Thanks, Mr. Hammond. I really appreciate this. You won't regret it.
I'm not doing it for you. I'm doing it for Smithy. And call me Ray from now on. Goodbye. I hate to be disturbed at this time of night. This stinks. Let's find her and see what's behind this curtain. The hotel next door, a place for hookers and suspects. I can't leave without my basic stuff. It's almost 2 a.m., time for my daily dose of scotch. I can't leave without my basic stuff.